by this outcomes. And it may be dysfunctional or functional, depending upon the outcome. And dysfunctional means if the situation give a negative reaction, it is negative stress is dysfunctional. And if the outcome creates positive energy, positive reactions, it is functional stress. And the influence of stress may also with the intensity. If you have high expectancy towards the outcome, our intensity towards stress may be very light. Or our reactions towards an unknown situation, in unknown situations our reactions may be high, and it has high intensity towards stress. Then the effects of stress, yes, of course stress is detrimental to the both physical and mental health of persons. Then move on to the stress at work. So stress at work can be explained as job stress or occupational stress. Then we have three different environmental factors for the stressors. He give concentration to the negative environmental factors is contributed to the occupational stress. And in case of this second definition that is given by McGrath in 1976, he concentrated on a reward-demand conflict. So in workplace there is reward-demand conflict, and this reward-demand conflict creates job stress. And move on to the third definition that is given by Weymouth in 1977. Here the concentration is the physiological and psychosocial homeostasis of workers. And all these definitions are concentrated to job stress in different dimensions. And from this, it is clear that job stress emanates from three major sources. The job itself, the job environment, and the employee. See, of course, in job situation, there are different factors influencing persons which leads to stress. In banking industry, so the studies related with banking employees. So in banking industry, from my observation, it is clear that monotony and complexity of tasks are the main two factors influencing employees during their work. And under so many factors related with job and environment, like long working hours, work overload, the attitude of superiors, attitude of subordinate, harassment, then penalties for minor mistakes, frequent transfers, these all are come under job environment factors, and then the employee. So personality made different. Every person are unique. So in difference in personality, their perception, their social skills, all those things contribute to the causes of stress. Then move on to job stress in women. So male and female are equally prone to job stress or stress. But the psychological, emotional, physiological and sociological differences in these human beings may influence the incidence of stress. Then job stress in women employees in banks. So in India, this banking industry demands too much consumer-centric or customer-centric approaches or personalized services. And because of that, the employees spend much of their time to their customers. And long working hours, frequent transfers, work and life balances, then internal politics or other, these are some of the problems faced by employees. These are only overview. Then based on all the factors, that is stress at work, stress in job stress in women employees and in women employees in banks. So numerous factors causing stress in job and job environment, and the incidence of stress in banking industry is much different from that of other fields, and therefore we have identified by the researcher as a result of events or extensive literature review that it is better to conduct a comprehensive study of stressors influencing women employees in banks. And thus, in this juncture, the problem is stated as an empirical study on job stress in women employees in selected banks in Kerala.